sound working? Welcome to our act of remembrance in this strange year of 2020. So we thank you for being here, and we think of all those who cannot be with us but are with us in spirit. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. The prophet Micah said, "What does the Lord require of you but to do justice, to love kindness, and to walk humbly with your God?" We meet here together with Almighty God, whose purposes are good, whose power sustains the world he has made, who loves us though we have failed in his service, who gave Jesus Christ for the life of the world, who by his Holy Spirit leads us in his way. We remember before him and commend to his sure keeping those who have died for their country, two world wars and in conflicts past and present, those whom we knew, those whose names are recorded here, and all whose memory we treasure, and all who have lived and died in the service of mankind. And today, as in many wars, we remember those who in this year of pandemic have not been able to say farewell to loved ones, those who have died and been buried without the touch of loved ones with them. And we remember that sorrow and that grief that stays with us. And yet we commit each and all to God, that his touch may be upon them, his life renewing them. And so we commit ourselves to work in penitence and faith for reconciliation between the nations, that all people may together live in freedom, justice, and peace. And we pray for all who in bereavement, disability, and pain continue to suffer the consequences of fighting and terror. So now we're going to hear familiar words from Psalm 23.
The Lord is my shepherd, therefore can I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures and leads me beside still waters. Shall refresh my soul and guide me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You spread a table before me in the presence of those who trouble me. You have anointed my head with oil, and my cup shall be full. Surely goodness and loving mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
This year we have celebrated 75 years since the ending of the Second World War, but we weren't able to celebrate VE Day in May or VJ Day in August. We remember them still. We remember in our service those who for many times felt they were the forgotten army in the Far East, as we come at the end of our silence to hear the Kahima epitaph. The the First World War was a war to end all wars, so the Second World War did not end all wars. And this year marks 70 years since the beginning of the Korean War. And the work of our troops with the United Nations to maintain peace. And through each of the decades, we think of that service for humanity and for peace. We think in this year of all those who have worked in our services to support us as a nation through pandemic and to work on behalf of the Commonwealth, risking their lives in so many different and varied ways. So we remember those who gave their lives for us in war. A prayer. Ever living God, we remember those whom you have gathered from the storm of war into the peace of your presence. May the same peace calm our fears, bring justice to all peoples, and establish harmony among the nations. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. So we come to remember as we hear the Ode of Remembrance.
They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
Thank you.
tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow, we gave our today.
So we come to lay our wreaths in memory. We have wreaths from our uniformed organisations, from our community organisations, from the church on behalf of all in the parish, and from our MP for West Bromwich on behalf of that community and constituency, of which many in this parish are a part. So I invite people to come forward to lay their wreaths. Others I know have brought crosses to place. And if you'd like to come forward, keeping social distance, if you'd like to place your crosses in the ground around the memorial. So we come to pray. O God, the Creator and Father both of our mortal and immortal life, we give thee high praise and humble thanks for all thy sons and daughters who counted not their lives dear unto themselves, but laid them down for their friends, beseeching thee that they may be numbered amongst them who by faithfulness unto death are given a crown of life, according to thy most sure promise, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty and eternal God, from whose love in Christ we cannot be parted either by death or life, hear our prayers and thanksgivings for all whom we remember this day. Fulfill in them the purpose of your love, and bring us all with them to your eternal joy. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray for all those who suffer as a result of conflict, and ask that God may give us peace. When I say, may God give peace, you might like to reply, God give peace. For servicemen and women who have died in the violence of war, each one remembered by and known to God, may God give peace.
God give peace.
May those who love them in death as in life, offering the distress of our grief and the sadness of our loss, may God give peace.
God give peace.
For all the armed forces, Norway members who are in danger this day, remembering family, friends, and all who pray for their safe return.
God give peace.
For civilian women, children, and men whose lives are disfigured by war or terror, calling to mind in penitence the anger and hatred of humanity, may God give peace.
God give peace.
For peacemakers and peacekeepers who seek to keep this world secure and free, may God give peace.
God give peace.
For all who bear the burden and privilege of leadership, political, military, and religious, asking for gifts of wisdom and resolve in the search for reconciliation and peace, may God give peace.
God give peace.
O God of truth and justice, we hold before you those whose memory we treasure and whose names we will never know. Help us to lift our eyes above the torment of this broken world, and grant us the grace to pray for those who wish us harm. As we honour the past, may we put our faith in your future, for you are the source of life and hope, now and forever.
Amen.
And I invite you to join with me in the words of our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. So before our final prayer, and then an invitation to join me in singing the national anthem, which we're allowed to do today. Just a thought on the poppy. Many of you are wearing them, or if not, you might see one beside you. And we think of the glorious colour, the brightness of a poppy and the way it bobs in the wind. And we think of all who bring light and joy and life, and all who have given their lives. So we think of the joys and all that life can bring. We think of the red petals and we remember also sacrifice, that cost of blood. And we remember those who have died for our freedoms, for us, in all sorts of manner and ways. And we think of that cost for us as we go forward to maintain that peace, that justice for our world. And if you've ever grown a poppy, you know how fragile it is. Sometimes the wind comes and blows it away. And so we know that we need to treasure the poppy and to treasure each other's lives. And sometimes, as we think of the poppy and we think of the centre, we think of our part in the future. What are we to do to make the past worthwhile and the future filled with hope? So our prayer of blessing. God grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the church, the Queen and Commonwealth, and all mankind, peace and concord, and to us and all his servants, life everlasting. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
So we sing.
God save our gracious Queen, long live our noble Queen, God save the Queen. Send her victorious, happy and glorious, long to reign over us, God save.
Thank you all very much for being here today.